Hello students, welcome to our today lecture. In our today lecture we are going to discuss that how to detect multicollinearity. So basically there are four famous methods that are being used for the detection of multicollinearity. The first one method is correlation matrix. You can also create correlation matrix in Excel file as well. Basically, correlation matrix gives you the pairwise correlation between the independent variables. So when you make correlation matrix, and if the value of correlation matrix is above than 0.8, or we can say in percentage 80%, so when it is more than 80%, then it might be the case of severe multicollinearity. So you have to resolve this issue before going or before moving further for your analysis. So when you create correlation matrix, you have to see the correlation matrix values. If the correlation matrix values are above than 80%, then you have to resolve this issue, because this indicates that there is an issue of severe multicollinearity in your data set. The second method, which is being widely used for the detection of multicollinearity, is VIF, or variance inflation factor. When you estimate variance inflation factor, you have to see its value, and if its value is higher than 5, it means that there exists an issue of multicollinearity. If it is below than 5 or below than 4, in some cases we use 4 as reference point, but in some cases we are flexible to 5. If its value is less than 5, when VIF is less than 5, it means that there is no issue of multi in your data set. But if VIF, this value is greater than 5, then it means that there is a moderate issue of multicollinearity. But if it is greater than 10, above than 10, if VIF is greater than 10, so then it might be the case of severe multicollinearity, high multicollinearity. The next method which is being used for the detection of multicollinearity is tolerance. Basically, tolerance and VIF are the reciprocal or inverse of each other. As here mentioned, the formula of tolerance is 1 over VIF, the reciprocal of variance inflation factor. If the tolerance value is below than 0.2, then it indicates the existence of multicollinearity. When you calculate tolerance and if you see that its value is less than 2, then it means that there is an issue of multicollinearity. But if it is greater than 2, then there is no issue of multicollinearity in your data set or in your model. The last famous method which is being used for the detection of multicollinearity is condition index. When you apply condition index, if it is less than value, when its value is less than 10, so it means that there is low multicollinearity. You can run your model. But if condition index is between 10 to 30, if condition index value is between 10 to 30, then it might be the case of our moderate multicollinearity. But when its value is greater than 30, then it might be the case for high multicollinearity. So anything below 10 is not dangerous, but if anything is greater than 10, then it might be the case for multicollinearity. So in our next lectures, this is the theoretical series for multicollinearity. We will do all of these analysis practically when we run an software. So basically in our these lecture we are only interested to discuss all these things theoretically, but in our practical session we will do all these analysis live and practically on software.